You remember last year when the Republican Party was like full steam ahead attacking the Biden administration because of the supply chain issue? And in particular, they focused on one thing, how difficult it was for some parents to get access to formula. And it was true in a lot of areas of the country, it was difficult to get formula, to get as much as you needed, or the price could be highly elevated. Now, it was sort of a natural consequence of the supply chain issues we were having following a terrible pandemic that was made far worse by the fact that Republicans didn't care at all about what was going on. But regardless, there was some content to it and they made good on it with tweets like this. Photos of there being some, you know, formula at a US border facility, whereas at a store there isn't. This is what America looks like, and they love that stuff. They love the idea that like a migrant is getting formula, but some like pure good blonde white kid isn't. So they'd send stuff like baby formula should go to Americans before illegals. They should not have to be sadder. Marjorie Greene talking about how in California you can steal formula, which I didn't know was a policy, but apparently it was. And how now others can't, and they're, according to her, the Biden administration sending pallets of baby formula to the border for illegal aliens while American mothers are crying in the grocery store searching for it. So the supply chain issue was serious. They're using it to advance xenophobia, nonsensical. The issue is they appear to have forgotten about this entire thing because they're right back to not caring at all about whether good, blonde, milky skinned Americans are able to get formula. Because according to a new report, the cuts that they're proposing for people in the WIC program could result in as many as 1 million babies not getting access to the formula that they need. That's in addition, by the way, to things like fresh fruits and vegetables, other necessary foods. There's a lot of issues, but for some, formula is a big part of that. And up to a million or more could lose access to it based on the cuts that the Republicans are proposing. And I want to give at least a little bit of credit to some politicians, including Marjorie Greene, for her consistency on this. I don't mean that she's been consistently in favor of them getting access to formula. I mean that she also voted to cut the amount of formula that they could get last year. So it's just amazing how they'll use this to demonize migrants at the border and then immediately turn around and say, you poors think you should get formula, and just spit on them. And then all the while pretend, Anna, that they're the populace that are representing the forgotten conservative majority or whatever.
I mean, that's exactly right. They're not populist. Whenever they pretend to give a damn about what corporations are up to, and when they try to pretend like they're holding them accountable, typically it's over some vague message that they put out, obviously crafted by a PR agent that talks about the importance of diversity, but they don't actually mean it, right? Like, it's that kind of stuff that for some reason riles up Republican lawmakers, rather than the fact that these corporations, in some cases, like with the baby formula situation, have monopolized their rule. This country is ruled by corporate greed, which they provide cover for. That's the reality of the situation, right? Someone like Marjorie Greene, who just yesterday went after Representative Ilhan Omar for calling out the corporate greed associated with the rail companies and how that has led to all these derailments. Marjorie Greene's like, she's blaming it on corporate greed. It's really about the fact that we don't have safety protocols and workers are lazy and there's a labor shortage. I mean, yeah, the rail companies fired so many workers that they went from a million at the peak to less than 200,000, which is obviously not enough workers to ensure that everything's safe. Like, she protects, Marjorie Greene protects corporate greed on a daily basis. She is a goon for corporate executives, period.
Yeah, 100%. Yeah, it's convenient to occasionally mention somebody like this, but only again for the aspect of it that advances their culture war. And then it's immediately forgotten. The needs of people are immediately forgotten. Really fast, here are some of the programs that could be affected by these cuts that they're proposing. It's a $472 million cut from the Home Energy Assistance Program, $950 million cut from the Child Care and Development Block Grant, $582 million cut from HHS programs tackling the opioid crisis. So the money you need to heat your home, that you don't die in the winter, which happens frequently in all parts of the country, but Texas, it's very trendy there for that to happen. Child care, opioids,
Like, I mean,
again, I don't want to focus just on Marjorie Greene, but she loves talking about like fentanyl constantly. Like, people die every day in the opioid crisis. They keep pretending that they want to do something about it, and then they cut huge chunks of the funding away.
They use the most vulnerable people as pawns, as political props, as convenient tools that they'll dispose of once they become inconvenient. And that's what someone like Marjorie Greene does on a regular basis. She purports to care so much about the record number of overdose deaths we experience in this country year after year after year. But when it comes to funding programs that these people desperately need in order to rehabilitate themselves, in order to deal with their addiction and actually be able to survive and thrive in this country, she wants to cut the funding for that, right? Because these people don't actually matter to her. The only use that she has for them or sees for them is for her own political aspirations. And you're right, it's not just about Marjorie Greene. This happens with almost every Republican politician. Okay, when it comes to mass shootings, they pretend to care so much about mental illness in this country, untreated mental illness. We need to do something about that. But once there's a bill right in front of them that they can vote yes on that would provide the necessary resources to actually treat people with mental illness, they'll vote no every single time.
Yeah, and again, as we point out a lot, also in a slightly different form, a lot of the Democrats too. You know, in the wake of the mass shootings, the Democrats also both pretend to care and I think do care a little bit more. And they'll actually talk about what's actually causing it, which is the guns. But then, you know, they don't actually get rid of any of them or anything like that. Like, they might be a little bit more willing to identify the actual problem. That doesn't mean that they actually solve the problem. They say the right things about the minimum wage and then it doesn't actually get raised. So is that better? In some ways, but not really. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.